In 2012, the announcement of the Higgs particle rocked the world, leading to unprecedented media coverage. A scientific discovery in which thousands of U.S. scientists participated was blasted across the globe by over 1,000 TV stations to more than 1 billion people. Time magazine declared it to be Particle of the Year, and Fabiola Giannotti, leader of one of the teams who found it, a runner-up for Person of the Year. Science, the flagship journal of the American Association of the Advancement of Science, named it Breakthrough of the Year. Scientifically speaking, this discovery was a really big deal. The data used to make this discovery was recorded at a large particle accelerator called the Large Hadron Collider, or LHC. Although the LHC is located at the CERN laboratory in Europe, the discovery was an international one. Scientists from across the globe were involved in all stages of this discovery. Over 6,000 researchers from institutions in over 60 countries are currently participating in the LHC experiments. Nearly 2,000 physicists from the United States contributed to this effort, and the U.S. provides more researchers than any other country. These scientists came from 96 U.S. universities and research facilities in 33 states, plus Puerto Rico. Like all LHC collaborators, institutions in the U.S. built equipment at their home facilities and shipped them to CERN, although the engineering skills and technical capabilities stayed in the States. U.S. scientists also helped operate the experiments and played a major role in analyzing the data that led to the discovery of the Higgs boson. There are examples where U.S. scientists have had a key impact. For instance, Dr. Joe Incandela, a professor of physics at the University of California, Santa Barbara, was in the international spotlight on July 4, 2012, when he announced the discovery of the new particle as leader of a team of more than 3,000 scientists. The two detectors that independently discovered the Higgs particle, ATLAS and CMS, can be thought of as huge digital cameras, larger than a five-story building and weighing many thousands of tons. And they're not ordinary cameras. They have 100 million pixels each and can take 40 million pictures every second. By sifting through these pictures, scientists are better able to understand how the universe works. Fully a third of the cost of operating these detectors is borne by the U.S. Together, the U.S. Department of Energy and the National Science Foundation contributed about $165 million to the construction of each device. These agencies have a long history of funding fundamental research, resulting in technical payoffs, including such innovations as medical imaging and cancer treatment, material science, and high-performance computing. While the U.S. has supplied about 30% of the budget and manpower necessary to operate the LHC experiments, this number probably underestimates the impact of U.S. scientists on the LHC research program. Brookhaven National Lab provides the second largest group of physicists working on the ATLAS experiment, eclipsed only by CERN itself. The situation is similar in CMS, where Fermilab is the second biggest research group. The discovery of the Higgs boson is perhaps the best-known achievement of the LHC research program. However, the two experiments have made many other observations and measurements. Hundreds of American graduate students have written their PhD theses on research tied to the LHC experiments and have moved on into the country's technical workforce. America's strong commitment to fundamental research ensures that U.S. physicists will continue to play a central role in mankind's millennia-long effort to understand our universe.